Dmitry, who's doing full-time development work at the Krita Foundation, has been hard at work on the new improved layer docker for Krita 3. You'll have to wait for the next alpha of Krita 3 to get it. I have the test build here to showcase the new features. In the meantime, go follow me at NathanGDQuest or at Krita_painting, that's the Krita Foundation's account on Twitter, to know when the new release is out. Now for the overview of the new features. First of all, there are lots of new shortcuts and functions to manage layers with your keyboard. There's also an improved look and UX, which was designed by Scott Petrovic. Multiple existing functions have been improved to now work with multiple layers selected at the same time. Last but not least, you can now assign color labels to your layers and filter them. Let us start with the new look of the layers docker. It has been improved to now show you other parameters you want to change directly with your mouse, to give you a small thumbnail of all of the layers, but a much more compact look than the previous detailed mode. There are now clear separations between every element on every line. Nested layers are also way easier to read. When you toggle the visibility of a layer, you can see that it's now being grayed out, so it's easier to know as well if a layer is visible or not. I will pass on some details, but the new docker has been designed so it's way easier to read and to use. You can also note that the buttons to add a layer to a group or to remove it from the group at the bottom of the docker have been removed. Now, unlike before, the group function will automatically add selected layers to the group. Let's move on to the new and improved functions in the layers docker. Now you can do many things to multiple layers at once, like you can duplicate them with Ctrl-J, it works on multiple layers. You can group multiple layers together with Ctrl-G. You can add a clipping group, which is Ctrl-Shift-G. It's going to create some kind of clipping mask, as in Photoshop. And you can now also delete multiple layers at the same time by pressing Shift-Delete. And you can use all of these in combination with the improved selection tool, which allows you to select multiple layers at the same time from the canvas. Just keep the R and Shift keys down at the same time to add layers to your selection in the layers docker. You can now rename one layer at a time with the F2 key. Or you can press the F3 key to edit the properties on any amount of layers at the same time. This allows you to rename multiple layers at the same time. They will be named after what you enter in the name field, and Krita will automatically number the names. You can change the opacity of multiple layers at the same time, change the composite mode, add color labels, which we're going to talk about soon, and you can now also edit the properties like visibility, locking, alpha inheritance, and the alpha lock property. I'll drop in the fact that you can use page up and page down to navigate the layers directly with the keyboard, and you can use control page up and control page down to move a layer up or down in the layers hierarchy. And this is already available in Krita 2.9. All of the new and the old functions can be found in the configure shortcuts window in the settings menu. You can find them under the Krita and the layer category. And let's now look at the color labels and layer filtering, which is extremely useful on large documents. If you right-click on your layers docker, you will be able to add a color tag to any amount of selected layers at the same time. You can also assign color labels in the layer properties editor. To filter layers by colors, you have to click on the drop-down menu on the right of the composite mode. Krita will list the available color labels in the document for you. So for example, if you click on the green color, only the layers tagged in green will show up in the layers docker. You just have to click on the option named All to show all of the layers available in the document. An important note, when you filter layers, if there are layers that are selected but that don't belong to the color label you want to see, Krita will still show them in the layers docker until you deselect them. That's it for this overview. As part of the free training I'm working on, I will make detailed tutorials on the new features in Krita 3 when it is released. Until then, be sure to subscribe to the channel and to follow the Krita developers. Thank you for watching.